that I could see. I know that it is difficult in the online sessions, but at least get an idea of your eyes if I have answered to your question in a way that was what you expected. Okay, so now the idea really is, if you think about project management, then project management is something en vogue, I would say, today in many areas that formerly were just done in a, let's say, normal business approach. And this has an influence on the way how to do projects, how a project manager has to work with the team, with all the stakeholders, but also from the content. And of course, our world has changed, not just the pandemic, but even before, in collaboration, in the way people could interact with each other. And this is, I would say, the foundation for my, or I have to admit, our, so there are, of course, more people involved in those projects, approach to think about project management, maybe in a broader sense, and also to create tools to help making decisions for project managers. Okay, and just with these few words, I am going to share my screen. Now I have to check which one. Yeah, this should be the right one, I guess.
Yeah.
Now you should see a man. And I would say this man is looking at project management experiences. You have this light bulb as a symbol of the idea, but there's so much around. And of course, now you have to think about how to manage this. And I want to start with a phrase that goes back to Edward Deming. So I have to admit also that beside project management, my focus is in quality and lean management. And therefore it's obvious that Deming has to be in a lecture. And he stated, everyone is already doing their best. So we hope that. The problems are with the system. Only management, or the system management, can change the system. And that is really from the spirit what I want to do with you now, to give you an idea about why we have to think about the system and work within the system if we do project management. Before doing this, let me start with a few ideas of what types of systems do we have. Simple systems. That's simple, really simple. Only a few inputs, only a few combinations, and very stable relations. Think about a SIP. The other ones are complicated systems. People always talk about complicated things. But if you think about a complicated system, of course, you have many inputs, you have many combinations, but you have stable relations. Think about this watch with all the intersections, stable relations. And then we have complex systems. Complex systems, you have many inputs, you have many combinations, but you have dynamic relations. And this makes it quite difficult to predict. A complicated system, nevertheless, is predictable. A complex system, think about the patterns of clouds, the movement of clouds, or the weather that are dynamic. Each small element could change by the relations triggers the whole system. And that is what we see in business today. And of course, then in project management. There are so many different aspects. Okay, now you could say, well, that's a very, let's say, high level idea. Let's go to a normal project. Okay, let's do this. And then let's take a car. And you see here a project is normally conducted to make a system, a service, a new process rollout, a product, whatever we may have in that system. So a project manager needs to know about that system. And of course, more, his team has to create things within that system. Now you could also say, okay, that's similar to systems engineering. Yes, but it stops with the systems engineering, which is a straightforward process in a complicated system, the moment we introduce other aspects, people, costs, time, then it gets really complex. I think you all know. Oops, sorry. Now I have an issue here. Just have to make sure it works again. Okay. Now, oops, exactly. That was my problem here. Back. So if you think about a project, in many cases, we think about the famous project management triangle. Scope, time, cost. But how does this work? It is not three different parts and you have to choose how to get them a little bit into different ideas. No. They are interconnected. What does this mean? Each part of the triangle consists of various elements. Just take scope, the different parts and features of a product, the quality of the product, and don't forget all the individual parts. And these different elements can influence each other. Within the same aggregated element, for example, sometimes reducing the number of parts of a product increases the quality, the user friendliness of the overall product. But forgetting a major part, the brakes, may have an issue in the quality of the car. So, but this works across the aggregated elements, cost, time, scope as well. Sometimes improving the quality of a part may cost a lot of money. Sometimes it is more or less granted for free with another change. So in the end, those three are not indivisible themes. Like I said, different individual parts within scope or within time, time per work package connected. Here it's obvious, otherwise you do not need Microsoft projects, as I heard you're having some lecture or some exercises next time. And as I said, across each other. So have this in mind. Another point, project management always is with people. So we have to think about the stakeholder management. And now, what do you have? You have your team. Maybe that is easy, not always, but you know those people. hopefully, or at least at the moment, you can understand what they think and on. The next is, you always have suppliers. There, you have, of course, relations based on contracts, based on information. But we see already here, we start having maybe some company politics and on. So managing projects is a kind of social political endeavor as well. Then you have your customers. You know that customers are not really easy to understand, especially for products that are not very clear. What are their requirements? And you do not have a customer or customers, you have a huge variety of different target groups with different requirements, with different backgrounds, with different possibilities to get information, all this. And they are an integral part of the value stream and therefore of your project. They have to be treated as partners. And last but not least, don't forget, you have lobby groups, politics, but in many cases, other people you do not have on your radar that can, those people maybe significantly influence the way your project system and the parts in your project system work together. So we can speak about society, if you like, that has an influence. And now optimizing one of those elements, collaboration with your suppliers, does not optimize the system in this case either. So you have to know and manage the links between the different stakeholders. The dependency of action, reaction cycles, and this without losing your project goals out of sight. So I think you could understand it is really complex. You have all these things, and nevertheless, you have a goal. Conduct your project, get the results, okay? And think about also on another thing, at least in bigger projects. This is beyond the capability of one single project manager. So you may have a team. Today in bigger project, one speaks about a technical project manager and a commercial project manager as a team. Also this adds to the complexity. So to sum up this part, we have three systems in project management. The result of a project is always a system. Think about that car. The project itself is a complex system, different aspects, and you have stakeholders, part of the system. So my statement is project management requires system thinking, always. From the beginning to the retrospective view. If we accept this, we have to think about what is system thinking, why system thinking. I try to do this with a very, very simple sketch I found somewhere. the two guys on the top, they are relaxing, not on our side. This is when you individually optimize your situation, but at the moment, maybe if the other two are not able to empty the ship and shut the hole, close the hole, they will also be in trouble. So we have always to think from a holistic point of view. Of course, then we have to do individual actions, but all those have an influence. Sitting there has an influence on the speed you get the water out of the ship. And this, in a feedback loop, will give those two a hard time when they are going down and maybe the ship is sinking. So, back to the company and projects. What challenges do we have? If you think and agree that a project is a complex system, we have interrelationships and conflicting goals. An intervention in a system not can, it will trigger side effects and feedback loops, unwanted ones, and maybe some positive ones. The problem is the unwanted ones. The next point is, for decisions we do in a complex system, we do not have all information. And even where we have information, we cannot have a full overview on them. So we talk about wideness and intransparency when doing decisions. And as already said, we have a high dynamic of change. If we think about that, we have challenges that we could not meet with our, let's say, common thinking passes, or in this case, I would say pitfalls. Rational penetration, the attempt to understand everything in detail. Nice idea, does not work because the system changes too quickly and unpredictably. Another thing we must do in our real life in some aspects, otherwise we will get to the next problem, is clearance cutting. The attempt to focus on individual factors and leave the others out. Unfortunately, if we put later together the pieces of those imagined jigsaw, they are not matching. The last point is fading out. The attempt to ignore complexity. Linear methods and procedures may not work so easily. Think about that graph for a moment. Now, what are the consequences of that? We get a lack of orientation. If we go into the details and try to understand things part by part, the overall strategy is missing, or we lost the view of that. And with that, for sure, our customer needs. Then we have conflicts. Why? There's just a curve on the bottom. And both are right from their point of view. Do we have the right communication? If we have those conflicts and the lack of orientation, normally what happens is the nice word burnout or overload. You have stuff that is stressed, insecure, budget spent on the wrong things. Two difficulties, two problems that you should avoid in a project as much as possible. So the approach must change. The next thing I want to show, just to check here. Oops. Well, that was not, oops. Some difficulties here. Okay. Now, the next example, I think many of you know. Think about that. What do you see here? Tell me. I'm pretty sure some of you have already seen this picture.
Abraham Lincoln.
A face.
A face? Abraham Lincoln, yeah. You said. Okay. I'm pretty sure that you have not done what we do in many cases in business and project. And that is an analysis of details. Because when you focus on the detail, and that's exactly here, I'm pretty sure you will not be able to see Abraham Lincoln's face. So what you do in this case, or what you did, is you did a kind of pattern recognition. You tried to not going into detail and try to find the second digit after the comma, but you try to make it even a little bit unclear, or let's say you try to find vague interpretations of the very big squares. And then, yeah, you could end up in having in your view Abraham Lincoln's picture. And this is what we have to do on the management level of projects as well. I'm not saying forget about finances and forget about calculations, but we have to add this. Just a moment, I have a short problem with the little dog here because she's now.
Why don't you show us the dog?
Okay, so Lotte, here you are. I think you know that Kaminda, always when the family is leaving, and they are leaving at the moment, then Lotte.
Okay, you can say hello.
Oh, hi, Lotte. Say hello. Okay, no, Lotte, no. Okay, and that's the moment where she is not very happy. I'm not sure if she will bark, but we'll see. Okay, so don't be disturbed by that. Okay, in this way, we have to think about a different way how to do things. I'm not going into details of this saying, but the idea is the moment where we see we are not being able to climb above the line, we have to do something different. And that is where we started thinking about systems thinking in project management. Now, what is the idea or the basic cycle of systems thinking? It's a common understanding of the goal. In the middle, you see the system, an excerpt of the reality. a system is never ever the whole reality. Because if we accept it is Sri Lanka, you have the sea around you, a next country. If you take the world, yeah, two guys in the last couple of weeks went out of our atmosphere for whatever reason. So you see, reality is always bigger than your excerpt, but you start in a kind of excerpt and then you do an abstraction. You have different perspectives of people and you do the pattern recognition. With that, everyone gets his or her mental model. So 1, 2, 3 could be 100. Now you have to align these mental models. That means you have to communicate. That is where this famous leadership comes in. Also different kind of educations to form a common mental model. That is a mental model that is not the reality, that is an artificial idea of the system we are looking at, your project. And in this mental model, if we describe that with algorithms, we are able to simulate specific aspects and could, of course, compare different simulations and with that get an evaluation of different scenarios. And this is why we do a simulation. We have a current status. Where are we today in our goals? Think about a moment in a project, midtime, and now we have the target descriptions. What state do we want to reach? That should be hopefully what we agreed on either in our project charter, classical way, or in our backlog if you think about agile project management. Doesn't matter. And now we have to go from here to here. What do we need? What can we also do to go from there to there? It's like you have your GPS and it gives you 3 different routes from A to B. And then the question is, it depends on the circumstances. Do you have a traffic jam somewhere, an accident, whatever, which of them may be better? It's not the GPS that decides, it's you, but it gives you an information, an additional information, and then you decide. Maybe you have also some other aspects to decide. If you have a longer way and it may be faster for any reason, let's say a traffic jam, but you know that you do not have enough fuel, or in my case, battery capacity with an e-car, you may say, yes, it's a good idea, but it does not work for me. That is your decision, but the simulation can give you some ideas, and that is what you want, or what we want. So overall, we are talking about strategy development, different activities, options, and an evaluation of results. And here the simulation can contribute why better than just, let's say, the ordinary reasoning, because we have all these interconnections that are, at least for me, maybe some of you could deal with 500 relations and see all different interactions, not me, sorry. That's why simulating makes sense. And this is where we talk about active networks. But think about such a network. Don't try to understand the German words. You see here a network And the first thing is we have to describe the system boundaries around, as we said, an excerpt of a reality. Next thing is we have to describe system elements, the huge parts where we see a major influence on our overall goal. We'll see that with project management in a minute. And we have to think about description of cause-effect relations. And here we have to think about different aspects. The first is strength and effect of the relationship. That means, is it reinforcing or counteracting? Let's give my laser pointer. Because here you see this one seems to be stronger than this one. And the direction has an influence. Here, this will be important. This is a kind of self-influencing thing, which means, for example, think about your own capability using technical equipment. If you are not learning, if you stop learning, you will not stay at the same level. Your level will decrease. And even more if you compare that with others. So then we have to identify the chain of effects. For example, from here, we can go to here. No, that was a bad option. Let's say from here, we can go to here, from here to here, from here to that one. So we have, sometimes you end up in a kind of feedback loop over three or four steps. Again, I'm not able then to think about the effects or to get a kind of evaluation. That was what is here, the cycles. And the description of momentum, also this we will see in a minute. That is the impulse, the delay, and all those things may not be linear. So what we have is, in the end, that this active network set the framework, and you could visualize the relationships. Okay, simple enough. Then we can add another complexity, and that is all these relations could have different strengths and causes. Linear, easy. If I add 10 points to one element, I always get 2 for the next one, 24, easy. But we could have saturations. Quite often, think about even, let's say, a saturation curve? Well, you give me a kind of idea where you may find saturation between a cause and an effect.
Acceleration of a car.
Sorry?
Acceleration of a car, where you
acceleration of a car. At the moment, you may have even the limit, not just the official limit, but in my e-car, set to 130 kilometers per hour. Yeah, but that could work also if you think about the employee satisfaction. If you appraise the work of an employee, that's good. If you do it again and again and again, always in the same way, at the moment, yeah, it's nice and it's on a higher level than on a lower level. By the way, works with incentives as well. At the moment, I think for pesos, the incentive of a couple of thousand euro will not have the same effect than for you and me. Okay. Another one, S curve. Quite often we have this. Think about quality management. If you have a very bad product and you increase it in quality a little bit, your customer says, doesn't matter, still not working for me. In the middle, you really get something good. At the end, again, perfect, more perfect, the most perfect one, doesn't make sense, okay? Gaussian curves, that's very strange, though you have to be, yeah, let's say very serious if you see you have such a thing, because this means you get a positive impulse and at the moment a negative impulse. Here again, from team management, an idea where this Gaussian curve has an influence. Think about the structure for the work. If I'm as a boss, tell you, if I give you no information, I leave you, just do whatever you think. It will not be very good for maybe the result and also for your own feeling. The more you get a structure, the better it is. But at a moment, it will decrease if I get over the point where your creativity is limited by my strict rules. You are just using a biro, not a pencil. Things like that, okay? And now back to our relationships. We have also a kind of delay. So we have, for example, an element one, and we have an action on that element one. Let's say plus 20 points. So from 40% to 60%, easy. If that element one is connected with element two, let's say in that linear way, then you get an increase of 6 points due to the linear relation for element two, but one round or one, let's say, time period later. If this element two is related with the next one, element three, now in this S curve, and we have this plus six in element two, the next round, the element three, will get 10 points plus, because here you have a very steep increase. At the end of the three rounds, the action with 20 points on element one changes element one of 20 points, element two by 6 points, and element three by 10 points, as an example. So that is what we simulate in such a systems thinking model, okay? Now, in a nutshell, this gives you the idea. We are going to the end of the theoretical part. System thinking is for seeing the whole picture. And we have to understand a few things. One is what the system looks like, our mental model, the boundaries of the regarded system, how it interacts with the environment and the systems around it, different systems. That optimizing one component does not optimize the system because you have the other things, can hog resources also. This is the major thing. And continuous attention to the dependencies and interactions is vital. This was complex systems. I want to add, before we really do this in an exercise where I need your contribution, because you are then the project managers, I want to give you an additional aspect, and that is that if you think about project management in our famous VUCA world, now why is it not going to the next? Okay, you see dynamic capabilities now?
Yeah.
Okay, because I had some issues with my screen. Okay, so you may have heard about the dynamic capabilities that are quite today an idea how to steer a company beside the so-called core competences, because core competences is something stable. Dynamic capabilities, we had this also in our systems. We are talking about dynamics. So the four ones created in the early 2000s was sensing capacity, recognize opportunities, customer demands, technology options for the project management. And you have to think about that. Integrating capacity, that means combine different activities and establish creative combinations. Again, obvious for project management. Coordinating capacity, yeah, no brainer for project management. You have to allocate tasks and resources and manage the network. And learning capacity. It's not necessary to make one error 20 times to really be able to do it whenever you want to do it. There are so many other possibilities to make errors. So you have to establish and question your knowledge, external idea and internal one. And I, for project management, would add to other one, that is reconfiguration capacity, that is the ability and the willingness, the second one, willingness to adapt to new situations and to best practices. And this, if necessary, during a project. It is not the best idea to say, we have set our goals, we have had some ideas how to do it. The situation has changed. Hi, pandemic. And we still continue to do this. So we cannot do a lecture online. By the way, I should have been 2 weeks ago in Sri Lanka, Kaminda. Yeah, we have to reconfigure the situation. And, come on. And my system thinking capacity, if it may show up. Oops, sorry. Hey, it's so slow now. Back. So system thinking capacity. See the whole picture, choose decisive elements, and model the interactions. And back to my picture. We have the real world. If we are not going into system thinking, we will get information feedback as the two ones. We will do decisions, implement the decision, and see what happens in the real world. If I'm going to think about systems thinking simulations. We create mental models of the real world in a holistic approach. We could do some simulations and use those simulations to hopefully do better decisions or to have at least a better idea why you do the decision. And sometimes even this helps you as a project manager if you can convince your boss why you need more money, because you could show that the decision makes sense in specific situations. Okay, that is so far the theoretical part that I want to show you, because the next one will be just one slide here, and that is simulating a complex project and its management in a, let's say, mental model set. Here, of course, for learning ideas. So we have a case study, we have a set scenario. Here, company, small company, will see when we start the simulation that should develop and help an OEM for a new hybrid engine, and the relations in our project management. And here, what you can see is that we try to build this simulation on four different areas. One is the competences of the company. There you have the qualification of the project team, obvious. You have the problem solving competence. This is more organizational learning. We have the technical infrastructure also as a, let's say, competence or an asset. Here, oh, you couldn't see, that is the processes, adaptability to new situations, the communication and data handling, the efficiency, then the benefits or the results we want, of course, a project result, the customer satisfaction. This could be or should have a linear correlation, but it is not the same. And we should also think about the employee satisfaction, because unsatisfied employees, you could imagine what happens, especially if you have to do a new project with the same guys. And that's why we also talk about potential, lessons learned from one project. You may increase or reduce your competitiveness with the project results, but also with the customer satisfaction and the employee satisfaction and other aspects you will see. And last but not least, the economic result of the company that of course has an influence on other things. For example, straightforward on the technical infrastructure you can build for the next project. So this is the model we are going to use. And yeah, from this I would say, let's play. Raminda, if you like, you can of course have and share the slides with the students.
You have not sent it to me, right?
No, not yet. Sorry, because I adapted some of them this morning, and I have to supervise some exams. I adapted.
You can also share. Maybe you can share in the chat directly.
I have to make a PDF out of this, but I will try to do it in a break. Okay, or at latest after the class, and then you can share it. Okay, now we are going to do the simulation. What I would propose is, because I also have to set up a few things, that we make a short break. Come in there, you tell me how long.
10 minutes.
Okay, so let's have a 10 minutes break. It's 10 to 5 here. So talking about 5. Yeah. Which is then 5, 9 with you? No. 8.
It's okay. Yeah. Our 8:30.
Yeah. 8:30?
Yes.
Ah, 3.5 hours.
Yeah, we'll start at 8:30. We start. Now it's 8:18 now, Sri Lankan time.
Okay. So at least 10 minutes.
Yeah.
And then I have set up the simulation, and there you, all of you, have to contribute. There I will just be the facilitator. If you are not going to give information, the company will be in bankruptcy.
Well, so you want also to create breakout rooms for them to work in small groups or not all together? Okay.
Yeah, I think it makes sense in this. I normally do this with the simulation, but then we have to set that up and we need a lot of more time and preparation.
But we can set up the breakout rooms?
No. I'm not talking about the breakout rooms, but about the simulation and how that could be handled. And I think that gives not additional benefit in an hour's or 1.5 hours simulation.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So see you in 10 minutes.
So if you have any questions meantime to ask from me or tell me, I'm available, so I don't take that break. So I'm here so we can chat, and by you can also take a break if you like. I will repeat again. Now, please pay attention to your chat function during the session. I will talk to some of you and ask something, and I need you to reply back. All the two guys have not responded to me. Okay, number 1967, WD1967, please change your screen to have your first name.
that is an important part. You see, there are a lot of inputs, but also, of course, a huge impact on the project result. Makes sense. That is the optimization of actions in order to achieve a desired goal. You see, potential risks are often not given enough attention, as the initially done risk management is not always updated. That is usually the case, unfortunately, in projects. You do that at the beginning, but then the update is quite boring as long as you have no problems. And then by a sudden, shit happens. Okay. Communication and data handling. How you do this, and you could see here, this is a key in project management. And here I will show you, for example, some ideas of the relations. If you think about the technical infrastructure, of course, gives you something for the communication and data handling, part of it. The better your technical infrastructure, the better you can do your communication and data handling. That is, for example, here, the relation. And you see already here, it is reinforcing, which means, of course, the better. It is so-called weak. So we get 20 points, which means if you change by 100 points the technical infrastructure, you will gain 20 points for communication and data handling, just as an idea. Okay. Oh, by the way, here it's still in German. Then adaptability. You see, that has something to do with effectiveness and flexibility. And we are talking about the potential of changing things. This has an influence on efficiency. This has also a big influence on problem solving competence, but the problem solving competence has also an influence on the adaptability. Makes sense, right? So in that, then we have the employee satisfaction. I think it's not necessary to explain this, but you can see here this nice little self-driven dynamics, which means if I do nothing, the employees will get gradually dissatisfied. That is something we know, and we have also to think about that. If I pamper my employees quite a lot, and then for any reasons I couldn't do this any longer, it will also have a very negative effect. So think about this. If an employee knows every week I get a bonus and 1 week you are not getting the bonus, the employee, at least in Germany, will not thank you for the last 50 weeks, but he will ask you, why not this week? So customer satisfaction, yeah, same. You could imagine customers are quite demanding. And of course, this is by the project result, but also by communication. It has a strong, here weak, but it has an influence on the competitiveness. Project result, obvious, here you will have a lot of incomings from all different areas. Lessons learned. Again, something we should do each step. And here I want to explain you also the indicators, because in a simulation, we also have to think about how could we judge one of those elements. In your simulation as a case study, it is not so important. But if you think about trying to do this for a company, it is necessary that you have a common understanding. How do I judge my, for example, lessons learned? And this could be the opportunities to participate for all people, the transferability of the results, and the documentation of the results. Makes sense. Competitiveness and economic result, I think, is self-explaining. These are the elements and, of course, the relations. And again, with competitiveness, you see you have this self-driven dynamics, because if you are doing nothing, the others will get better and you stay, which makes you get worse in relation. Okay, this is the setup. Now, what we have is we have variables. We have resources. Here we just talk about some credit points, very important. We may have incidents, different things. I will not show to you because this will be what you get later. But you have actions. Here, of course, in this, let's say, gamification, that are preset actions from my side. You can choose the ones that may fit to some incidents. You can also do some prevention actions. If you think about, or you see some elements are getting worse, you can do something before a real issue happens. If we take, for example, such an idea, let's make collaboration with an university. Then of course, you see, you have some resources to put into that, 10 credit points. There could be conditions set. Here you can use this 2 times. And now the important thing is, and you will see during the simulation, what are the impacts? Impacts are direct impacts. So for example, we have an impact on the problem-solving competence. I hope you agree that makes sense if you have the right university collaboration in your project. It helps you to solve some competence, also to be more adaptable. Here, you only have the direct ones. But if you think about our problem-solving competence, you see our problem-solving competence, for example, also here has an influence to communication and has an influence on project results, which means if I take this one, strengths, 20. So if I take the university in, I may have a better problem solving competence, but indirectly, I get a better project result due to the higher problem solving competence. So that is how it works. And then you could understand how it goes. Let me see what I still have to tell you. Okay, impacts, subsequent incidents. Okay, there could be, due to an action, also a new incident. Here, for example, a positive one, you see a probability because not always things will one-to-one happen. There is a chance that you get a breakthrough advancements in the project development. And this, of course, triggers new things. And don't forget, normally that are different stakeholders that could play the different actions. And Kaminda, that is what we can do in breakout session if you really have the time and you know all the details. But yeah, then we need more time. Okay, so far I think it's obvious. The same works, for example, if you take enhanced ergonomics at the workplace, for example, what do we have? Hey. Maybe my mouse is faster than the brain of the computer. Here again, you see the impacts, employee satisfaction, efficiency going up. Are there any conditions? No. So that could be. But let's say here, takeover of project management. Of course, this only could be done if the existing project manager resigns or is kicked out. Okay, now this is the actions. Scenarios, yeah, we will do the standard, but a test in the beginning. Now what we can do and what is important, and we will do this round by round also, is that we have an influence matrix. And this gives us at that very moment, here at the beginning, it will change, it is dynamic, how the different elements are playing in the system. For example, a passive element, which is the efficiency. Here, you see, has ins, one out, but it has just a lot of ins. If you take, for example, a very active one, that is communication, you see there are a lot of strong out relations, then it is active. That means when I change something here, I have a huge impact on different elements. Critical, problem-solving competence. You can imagine what that is. You have a lot of outs and ins, which means that is an element. If you change something there, it changes the system, but it is itself changed by a lot of others, which means when I change one other, this may be changed and this changes a lot of others. So that is to be recognized at that very moment. Don't forget, not nonlinear dependencies, this will change. What you can do, we will not use too much, is that we could also check and say, what are, for example, change of influences? Let's imagine we have our qualification of project team, we improve. What does this has as result to our project result? And then we see that we have 13 different ways, different lengths. The qualification of the project team has a higher problem-solving competence, and this gives better project result. Another way is to say qualification of project team, problem-solving competence higher. This is not just giving a better project result itself by the competence for the project, but also the people will be more efficient, and this gives, again, something to the project result. Of course, this will have a weaker influence because here it is strong, here it is very weak, and then it is strong, but this triggers, of course, think of what I showed you before, then the result. And so you see, ways longer than four, forget that is a kind of drop on a stone, on a hot stone. That does not make so much. Yeah, and now we are going to simulate. If my computer is accepting to simulate. Dear God. Now, we create a new simulation. We do the test simulation. So we forget about what that is. We choose the test simulation. Okay. And now you start working. I'm just clicking now. We'll start that simulation. We have different rounds. You see, we start. And then let's see. Okay. Now, in the first quarter, we have started our project. We get an update of our project management software. Let's see what it means. Software used for the project. Now I have a feedback. Okay. So software used for the project receives new updates and new functions. Seems quite good, right? What are the impacts? Our technical infrastructure is improving. The communication and data handling is improving as well. Why do we at that moment think that the employee satisfaction is negatively concerned? What do you think?
Because they have to learn the new methods, how to use it. So it might take time.
Yeah, exactly. That is what we thought in this simulation. The employees appreciate this, but not at that moment where they had to work on the project hard to set up everything, and it takes time. And by the way, you have to learn. So that is what we have to think. Okay, now you decide. You have now a lot of options of actions. You see, of course, some are lined out, which means they are not to be used at that moment, because the conditions are not for that. I could not schedule weekend work if I have not yet any issues. My labor unions will immediately say no, okay? So if you have a look on the different actions, you tell me what you think we should do. We have the software. And then I will show you what those actions give you, and you decide which one you choose.
Do we have to choose individually or as a whole group?
Sorry?
Do we have to choose individually or as a whole group?
In a way, as a group, so one has to make a proposal, and then you may discuss. I think at the moment it's quite straightforward, but you will see in the real run later, then there could be discussions. So one is going to start.
My personal opinion, I would start with the A20 software training.
Software training. Let's see what that is. anyone who is in favor of this, thumbs up, or those who really disagree, okay, at least you have one thumb up, a few others. Here, I think it is a straightforward situation. What will happen is that we have the reduction of the employee satisfaction, but we will cover it by the training. So we will not be better later, but at least have reduced the negative impact. Okay, so let's choose that one. Anything else you want to do right now? We are in a test run, so you can do whatever you want. If we crash the project, no problem. It's just a test run of a simulation, not the reality.
A12.
Exchange of project stuff.
12.
Okay.
No, he said 12.
Team building.
12, okay. Sorry, I was a little bit surprised, but can do this. Okay, by the way, here. So you see, it costs quite a lot. 15 credits out of 85 we have in total. No problem for the test run. We just have 6 rounds. But in the real, we have to think about that because it is the difficulty if you run out of money and then something happens. Okay, but this is, of course, something which goes a lot into the problem-solving competence. Why? Because people know each other. They could also use the different competences of people in a team. You know, that team building seminar, you learn about your comrades and then people are more satisfied. In this case, you have efficiency and communication goes up. So let's do this, why not? And let's go to the next round, I would suggest, okay? Now we see, yeah, okay, that's obvious what happens. So what happens? We see our total performance, that is the weighted average of all, has increased. What you see here is what will happen in the next round. Qualification of project team will go down due to the self-dynamics, always. The same here for employee satisfaction. Problem-solving competence will go up due to the last activity we do. Have this in mind. And on. So you could also see where you may have to act. At the moment, it seems quite good. We can do a kind of analysis. Oh God, it takes so much time here. It's just, influence matrix. I just want to see the influence matrix. So not much has changed here so far. And here my evaluation. We have employee satisfaction kept stable, even though we had this risk of going down due to the new software. That was not the right time. The rest is going up, so not bad. And we continue to simulate. Okay. Now we have changes in project scope. What does this mean? I'm pretty sure you know that. The classical one. Hey guys, only just a little change. I want this red instead of blue, but you have already painted everything. And so on. So the small changes, big changes are normally not the problem. The problem in projects are the small changes. Come on, can do this in a minute. Please do it. No effort, yes. But 50 times no effort is a big effort. So that's what we have. And by the way, you see the customer satisfaction with small changes are normally not increasing because your customer says, come on, it's so easy for them. Okay, so but that happens, and now we have to think what to do. Again, let's see what we can do here.
A2,
improvement of communication with the customer. Seems not bad. So we virtual meeting makes sense. Even so, you see that my voice is hopefully being transmitted correctly, but the video not. So we have an interface between the customer and the project team. Costs quite a lot. What are the impacts? Not bad. But let's see, do we really want to have those impacts? 8 here, 7 here. Okay, why not? But we are quite good in communication right now. Okay, it is helping a lot. So let's do it. Anything else you can think of or you want to do?
Exchanging.
A6. Employee benefits. You are an employee? You feel like an employee in that? Or you feel like the project manager? Okay. Let's see what that means. Of course, yeah, an expansion of the employee offers and subsidized lunch is not too bad. As long as it is region for me, and on. Okay, impacts, employee satisfaction. Yeah, why not? But don't forget, it costs. Okay, but we have plenty of credits at that moment. Next round. By the way, plenty of credits. Even after 3 rounds, we started with 85. So good luck. Okay, where we are quite good. Why are we so bad in competitiveness? Let's see. Okay, nothing happens, so we can say relax, do nothing. Sometimes it is not the worst situation if all of your people are working good. So let's go to the next round. Let's see if there's anything new. Oh, nothing new. Do you want to do something at the moment? You can see what happens here. So here we are good. The project result is also increasing. Technically infrastructure, yeah, of course, that goes slowly below average.
A7.
I know that I could push you. Okay, what does that mean? I just want to make you out of resources. Again, a lot of things, but it works, of course, in the right idea. So let's do this and go to the next round. Okay. Seems not bad. I just go to the next one. Okay, almost done in this way. You could think of doing something new. Here you are quite good everywhere. The only problem, dear colleagues, is those two. You have not really increased your economic result and your competitiveness. Yeah, you have almost spent your budget in 5 rounds. In the real simulation, you are going to do 12 rounds. Okay, and you get not more budget. That's for sure. Here I'm strict on that. Now, any actions you want to do? You see, there's a lot now lined out. Why? Too expensive. You couldn't do that.
I would say with the current options, yeah.
Sorry?
No, with the current options, I should focus on economic research. So request of budget increase, A21.
Okay, this will not help your economic result and competitiveness of your company because you ask for a higher budget for your project. So the economic result will even go down. So just to make that information, it will not help. And by the way, you are anyhow at the end of this project simulation. So if you have more budget at the end, if they accept it, it will not help you. So, okay, let's just do the next round for the test, because I think you get now the idea, you get the spirit, and we will see. So we have the end of the simulation. You, of course, got better, but don't forget, we did just a short run. Now, just to make it a little bit clear. And I will just focus on a few. So now if you see this, apparently it's not too bad. Let's just have an idea on the satisfaction and results. So forget about this for a moment. On this. I go here, that makes sense. And I want to add element. Come on. I want to have nose. So, what do we see here? What we have to make it a little bit different in color. Okay. We did a lot for our customer. We did a lot for our employee. This gives our total score up. Okay. But honestly, the project economic result and the competitiveness has not really increased. So if that is a single project, and you know that it was done either because you had to do it for any reason to stay in contact with that important customer, it's okay. Also, if you think that it was not necessary because of the competitiveness to your competitors, because maybe that was in an area you are not focusing in the future, then you made everything right. If you want to have this project used for being more competitive in the market, it may not have been in many cases the right decision. And then you go back and think, what can I do? And this is what a simulation can help you. If you have goals and you have different goals and you want to check what you can do to improve specific goals in the setup, try it. And the positive thing of a simulation is it costs you just a little bit of time, but not a project to be crashed to know that that was the wrong decision you did. Okay. Let's go back to my analysis. A little bit changed here, but again, not much due to the effect. The only thing that changed, you may not have seen here in the communication that went even in the, it could not go further here in the direction, but it went. Okay, that was the test run. And now, any reflections from your side for the real simulation we do? If not, we go straight into the simulation. And here we will take a little bit more time for the different aspects, and you will see that unfortunately more problems will pop up. No, fortunately, because you want to learn something. Okay, new simulation, and now we do our standard. And we start. So same setup, same correlations, no card player's trick on my side. And we start. Again, we have our update of project management software. And you are going to tell me if you want to do the software training, not if you want to do other things. You could discuss with colleagues. If one of you gives an idea and another one is not agreeing, please immediately tell all of us and we can go into the discussion.
A7?
A7?
Yes.
You raise hand function. I use the raise hand function so Professor Srin will know you want to speak. Yeah.
Okay, A7. So we saw this, 25 credits. Our impacts are employee satisfaction, technical infrastructure efficiency. Are there any conditions? No. Okay. Should I log it in?
I would say A20 software training.
In addition to A7 or instead?
No, instead of A7.
So now you have a classical situation. You have to convince your colleague why A7 or why A20.
Because right now the situation where we have is there is only a software update, and we don't need a expansion, and we can't spend that kind of credits at the start without knowing our future aspects. So software training, I think it would be a small investment to convince the employees.
Okay, because your colleague made the idea of, look, here is a lot of positive influence, but you said, oh, look at this one. In the first round, spending 25 out of 85 credits may not be the ideal one. Is our colleague who said the 7A7 accepting this Isuri, or you insist on A7?
I would say in the last case, we have started with software training, but for this new case, we should start with something else to see, like expanding existing infrastructure and see whether we can do better than the earlier case. So that was my concern.
Okay. Only just as one information, we have now 12 rounds and we will have more incidents.
So, I think it's just worth going for 25 credits at the first step.
Make it easy. We will ask the group who is for A20. Ideally with sums.
19 raise hands.
Okay. Who is for A7? Just A7.
Only, I think, six people.
Okay, and who wants to lock in both? Okay, so
sorry.
Not many as far as I see.
Yeah, only the first.
So we start with A20, okay? Okay, let's go to the next round. What happens? We have our change in project scope. So the ones that pop up without any triggers will be the same. So same question, what are we going to do now? What would you try to do? We are good off in all aspects. Only employee satisfaction has decreased a little bit as last time. The normal degradation, we covered the software issue.
The scope, you mean the customer has redefined the scope, right? So
yeah, the same as last time. So customer does this minor nitty-gritty requests.
Does a request of budget increase works for this? Start
request
of the
of budget increase. The question is, do you think that at this moment the steering committee will give you that
request? Because of the scope change?
Yeah, but that are just the small changes. Now my question psychologically, do you really think your steering committee will at that moment, at the very beginning of your project, with small changes from the customer side, you still have 80 of your 85 credits, give you that request? You just requested that. If you fail, I'm pretty sure you will not go into a request successfully when it is necessary. And understand the idea, and that's what a simulation should also do. Not at the end, the result is one thing, but to question you or in between you, those things. So sorry when I say, and this time I wouldn't do it.
A12?
A12, we have a team building seminar.
I guess we can try this since most of the impacts, it's showing it's going to reduce in next round.
Okay, who's for that? Not so many. So what are other proposals? We have here 41 participants, excluding Raminda and myself. So,
I think A13 consulting external consulting group.
Oops, sorry.
No, it takes so much resource, 30.
Again, not too bad, by the way. Don't forget, you have an impact on qualification of the project team. You have also employee satisfaction in this kind. I do not know who of you had the experience in a project when your project manager comes to you and says, oh, I think it's better to have some external consultants in here because we are not able to do it ourselves. Okay, there are good reasons for doing this. The question is it the moment? Come on, there are so much others. Finish, Janaka, Darshan. I'm pretty sure I pronounce everything incorrectly, so you could hide. But
A17.
So put that out. A17. Reduce documentation effort. Why that one?
I think it will increase. It will cost. I think it will cost lesser amount, and at the same time, it will increase the efficiency of the project, and also it will increase the employee satisfaction and also the customer satisfaction as well. Mm-hmm. If the processes are smooth, then if there is less documentation.
I agree, efficiency. I also could tell you, you are more adaptable. But don't forget, if you have a bad documentation or the documentation is less stringent, you may have issues on problem solving, especially if people are leaving. The customer satisfaction may also be reduced because the documentation is also something for the customer. You could not give the customer full information. And of course, on lessons learned, you will lose. So, but okay, it gives you something for efficiency, for less or for just a low amount of resources. But again, is it the right time to do this?
Okay, let's maybe let's try again A2.
A2, yes.
Yeah, A2 and A19 is also, we can try. Since we have the issue with the customers, we can try both those options.
Okay. Yeah, so let's do this. We can discuss this later if there is another option, but yeah. But honestly, it makes sense. It has a lot of money you spend, but trying to improve the customer the communication with the customer at the end does not really help you too much. So if you are going to do this, that is the moment. Absolutely okay. The question is if it makes sense in your project, yes or no. So let's do that. Oops. Next round. Yeah, now we have our project expansion.
Can you show us the...
Sorry, yes. Good argument. So now others.
A10.
A10, take cooperation partner on board. Why not? So the idea why this popped up just from the idea we put into the model is you had this communication with the customer. It helps also in a way, but have in mind, now the customer also knows better what you can do and what you may also offer. So you see the two sides of the medal in the communication. Okay, so cooperation partner, okay, gives you technical infrastructure, gives you not immediately efficiency, but we know that the technical infrastructure has a big impact on the efficiency in a second step. So if you take this, to the communication and data handling and from there to that. So not too bad, and it does not cost much. Why does it not cost much in comparison with the university? The partner, of course, will have an influence maybe a little bit on your economic result, but it's not going into the budget because partnering means that he will participate on the final result. So that's the difference between the university where you have to, let's say, pay for the effort. Okay? Or the consultant. Next round. Okay, we still have a half an hour. Okay. Ah.
Hey. 20 minutes. We are finished.
Okay. Nothing. Yeah, we will achieve that. Otherwise, I have to push people that we will lose too much money and we will abandon the project. No. Okay, so nothing here. So let's go and give the people a kind of relax, see what happens. Round five, nothing. Nothing. That's strange. My favorite ones. You're experienced in that. Now, we have a big problem. We have a big problem. We all know that, our pandemic. You see what will happen with the efficiency. You see what is going to happen with the problem solving competence due to my high sickness rate and the pandemic with all the impacts. This will highly impact the result and of course our employees. So great, what may happen now? What can we do?
Nancy, play for us. A9.
A9? Non-sick leave bonus, okay. What do you assume by that? You assume that the people are not real sick, or at least not as sick as they could not continue to work.
Yeah, they may be faking.
Okay. Fully accept it, but have this in mind and don't forget this assumption also plays a role in your system. So have this in mind. It is okay. And let's see the impact. Okay, you have the employee satisfaction and the efficiency going up, but don't forget this may have also an impact on other employees, or only as an idea, you know, because.
Can we also try A8?
Sure. A8, you mean you enhance ergonomics at the workplace? Yeah. I'll do this, but again, don't forget in the back, you have also some correlations. And of course, this helps, but it will not help you in the pandemic itself. So have this in mind. And
maybe A17,
A11.
So now I have a lot. So we have the A17, we know what that is. A11, exchange of project staff. So you kick them out and hire new ones, okay? Come on, be a little bit more realistic.
A12.
Team building seminar online, right?
What about A16?
A16, parallelization of work. Okay, employee satisfaction going down. So you have to compensate, but you get efficiency, you get adaptability, which is also, okay, it's still high, but it's going down. This may, of course, help, but.
Why don't you try A6?
A6, employee benefits. So now, just to make sure that we understand completely what we have A6 as an idea, we have A8, we had A11, A16, and A17, right? So who wants A6? Come in there, you count.
Okay. Raise your hands, please. Yeah, raise hand, raise. Vote. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 8.
So then we had
10 votes.
What do we have? A8.
We have 4 words for them.
Okay. Then we had A11, as I understood.
3.
What else did we have? We had A16.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. There are 11, 12, 13.
Okay.
15.
And what did we have also? A17, I think, right?
A6, I remember. It is 3.
3 votes.
Okay. Now, let's say we have A6, 10, A16, 11, the rest quite low. So who's for only A10?
A6, forget it.
A6, who is only A6?
We can't see what is in there, the A6.
Okay.
Employee benefits.
Sorry, just a moment. A6. Oops, sorry. No, oder mag er jetzt nicht? Okay, here. Now, here we are.
You have 8 people.
Okay. Who wants only A16? A16 is this one.
Nine, 10 votes, 11.
Okay, and who wants both?
Four people.
Okay, so we have A16, right?
No, A6 got, I think, more, 11.
Okay, then we have the A6. Okay. And we go to the next one, next round. Okay. You see, nothing happened so far, but we are going down in efficiency, qualification of project team, project result. Okay, this is depending on that. You have been very, very nice, gentle, social bosses. But hey, guys and ladies, we have a project result. So what should we do? And our budget is also decreasing, but still no argument, let's say, for our bosses to increase the budget. But you see, we focused a little bit much, if too much is another question, on our employee satisfaction. And our customer satisfaction is still high, but with that project result and a decreasing project result, this will also have a negative effect here.
A18 and A16?
Okay, A16, why? Because you get into the efficiency, right?
Yeah.
Of course, it will not be appreciated by our employees, but sorry to be now bossy like, it is still over the average in your business. So we can accept this. Okay. Let's, due to time reasons, go to the next round. See what happens. Okay. Oh, we still are. Oh, I know I pushed you in there. But I said this at the beginning also. Have in mind, if you are on a specific level, people do not really like that their benefits, their well-being is reduced. And it doesn't matter if you are a bad employer or if you are a good one, the moment you really reduce things for the satisfaction of your employees, the people will be demotivated. You know that people sometimes in Western Europe are more demotivated than people in emerging countries. And sorry, they are mourning on a very high level and they have no reason to do this. But yes, if, for example, I could not have the amount of holidays I had before, this is a horror scenario, even though I still have much more than the rest of the world. So, but now we have this situation. We have demotivated employees. Shit. What can we do? And don't forget, that is not the big amount of people, but they may impact the mood of everyone. You know that if you work with someone who is always telling it's shit and this project and the project manager, this bad guy just pushing me and now I got no money as before. So what shall we do? Actions.
We have only 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Works, Raminder. Like in a project management, you have a deadline and you have to work faster. So tell me, exchange your project staff at that moment. What shall we do?
Again, reduce documentation effort.
Sorry?
A17, because we can't kick out and it'll be another burden okay. To retrain people.
At least it gives a little bit anything else. Don't forget, we are almost at the
Can
end.
Can we see some actions again?
Team building seminar, okay.
Sorry?
Team building seminar, A12.
Ah, the team building seminar. Ah, not too bad.
A80? Schedule weekend work?
You are going to schedule weekend work with demotivated employees and at the moment, not too much problem, if I correctly see this, on your efficiency. Let's go for our team building, at least to see what happens. Okay, we had this reduction, of course, but we lowered the impact. So that was what we had. And now we have just 5 credits, so let's think what you can do in the last 5 credits and minutes. Where do we have some issues? Project result. Unfortunately,
present cannot project schedule.
A15. Sorry?
A15.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Resource consumption should work, yeah. Okay. Okay, that was my point for the last. You did some pushes to the employees, but it was nothing that continues. You had the team building seminar, but it was not all on what was the basic situation. So, of course, forget this, we are in the last round, but just to give you the thing, you see what happened at that moment, you are now in this up and down circle, what you did. You give benefits, you hit them. Then you have the team building, you had a reduction and you pushed them by the schedule. So this is, how do you call this? In German, it is Zuckerbrot and Peitsche. It is a sweets and the whip. And at the moment, people say, at least, and now, and that would be the moment here, it's incorporated that the project manager resigns if the employee satisfaction is going down to a huge amount and the project result is not above the average. So this just had an idea next round, but we will see what that is. So, and now final short evaluation. And that was where we started to be inconsistent. As I said, sweets and whip. And this is something to avoid. Either you be very, not bad, but clear and hard. People could see that, or you are quite soft, but switching is for employee satisfaction, a situation people could not have an idea what to expect next. And this is one of, I think, you are not alone with that. In many situations, in many crisis situations, we started with the pandemic at that moment. And we had this in many companies here. You try to give, but then it's the wrong, you, inconsistency. Okay, and that was a little bit the idea. And this could help if you play this, at that moment you could maybe, and I hope also you for your maybe career as project manager, whatever, don't really react immediately if you do not know that you could stay with that for a longer period. So that is a training on soft skills, but I think it showed you also how things are connected. What we did, and that is coming to the last point I want to show. If we go and just see those three, I'm not going into the economic results, not here. And yeah, just on the three results, benefits. Well, you see, in the end, of course, I pushed you. We stayed always in between 40 and 60. But you acted, if we were here, we said, okay, I know I once pushed you in that direction, saying you could do that. Here, up, then you said, okay, it's okay, forget about this. We had this down, we will try to increase this. And in the end, we get a problem here. If it is the end of the project and you fire anyhow all people, okay, it is not nice, but for the company, maybe it's Yeah, okay. If you want to do something next with those employees, it is like I would now continue to talk 10, 15 minutes. It makes no sense because the end is in 5 minutes or 3 minutes. So have this in mind. And I think that is the only thing I would really like you to keep from that lecture, even if you do not a simulation like this. For yourself, try to figure and visualize the main elements and always think about, does this work in a midterm range and could I continue what I started to be clear and consistent and having all aspects included? That's the hard work of a project manager. And it's so easy for me to tell you, I'm 54 now, but as a young project manager, I learned this not because I did things correct, because I exactly did this. And not once, but in different directions, differently. Okay. Okay. I think that's it from my side. I hope at least you could get a few ideas, enjoyed a little bit the playing. I know normally this is a game for 3 to 4 hours, so half a day in different rounds with more aspects, but I hope you get a first idea.
Yeah, thank you very much. So now I think that's the plan. When you come to Sri Lanka in February, we will do this in real time.
The plan of February. We do not know which year, but February, okay?
Yeah, okay. But I am sure the students got a very good understanding about system thinking and how to use simulation for this kind of complex problem solving, as well as the real kind of touch and feel, even though they could do it. And of course, your personal experience as a long-term young 54 years old project manager. So I will not take time, but I want somebody to from the class to share their experience. Maybe Kuri, you can say something.
Thank you. Thank you very much, because it was a new method. And for me, this is the first time I have, encountered such a software. And I will certainly will learn more about it and try to, involve this in my line of work, utilize this. Thank you, everyone. And we would have, it would have better if we had more time to do, discuss more on selecting the action. Thanks.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Suren, you can stay. We need another 10 minutes. I want to give a quiz, like unplanned, previously unplanned, but based on what Professor Suren mentioned and discussed, I want to kind of cross-check whether they learned seriously. So I just did a short quiz. And so the normal rules apply. You have to write down your registration number, the name, and then immediately answer. Today only you have two questions. And I will give you around 10 minutes so that you can answer and submit. Now, there was a complaint that sometimes there's a limit of number of characters you can type for the in the chat. So be careful, don't exceed that. And also don't try to send me a Word file, just type inside the chat box. All right. This is quiz number 5. We have two questions. We go one by one. The first question, briefly explain the following terms as discussed during the session. System thinking, what do you understand by it? Your own words are fine. Huh? Simulation, projects as systems. So how can you explain to somebody they don't know the terms? Very brief answers are fine. System thinking, simulation, projects as systems. One or two sentences are fine for each. As I already mentioned to you, the purpose is to reward for people who are being here as well as actively participating and listening. Do not submit, huh? Don't submit now. Submit when I tell you. You have two questions. One, this is the first question. Okay, let me also go to the second question now. So this is an open question. What is your main lesson from today's workshop? Please explain. Explain in two sentences what you learn out of Swin's overall session on the system thinking or the simulation or anything else, as you think from your own words. I'll give you 3 minutes. Okay, 2 minutes to go. One minute. Okay, time up, please submit now. Submit only to me. I'm getting good detail answers, very good. I have to share, cut and paste. All right, so I hope everybody has submitted. Right, very good. Let me get all the answers. What is the select call from? Just a minute. Save chat. Okay. Then select call. Copy. Q5. All right, so nicely saved. Thank you very much. Thank you, Soin, again. It is a pleasure to see you and have your expertise back. Hope to contact you soon. And stay safe and take care of Germany till I come there, because I heard all the flooding and everything. So I'm a little bit excited. Yeah.
Oh, but Esslingen yes. was safe. Yeah. So. Even so, the Neckar was quite high, but it was safe in Esslingen. Okay, so
if they want to contact you directly, how they contact you for future references? If they want to contact you directly for any academic purposes, should
no,
they
no, link? No, no, no problem. You have the email.
Okay, email or also in LinkedIn, right? LinkedIn.
Yeah, LinkedIn is. Possible as well.
Yeah.
No problem.
Okay.
Okay. It was a pleasure. Yeah. Take care and all the best for your continuation of your studies.
Exactly. And finishing my class.
Have a nice evening. Yeah.
Yeah. We are going to have another simulation. They really do it after 2 weeks. So this your preparation was very good for them, so that they know how to run a simulation and what they understand out of that. Thank you very much.
Okay. Take care. Bye.
Ciao. So next week, we have to prepare for the simulation on the last week. But next week, I will give you some flavor of online software or MS Project software, and I'll introduce the simulation. But you have some readings to do when you come for the next week. I will share them very soon, maybe tonight in the portal. Okay, any questions?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. Today, I think you have done a good job, particularly in active participation, as well as, continuous being in the session. I still see 45 people. But when I am doing the session, I cannot track, Now, today I could track everybody, so it was good. Okay, ciao, bye. See you next
time. Good night.
Good night.
Thank you, sir. Good night.
Good night. Thank you, sir.
Good night, sir. Thank you.